Well, hello, my name is Fersonas, and why do I wave to someone next to you on the left? I don't know. I don't know why I'm looking to the left. Welcome to Ark Survival Evolved Update Patch 258. Yes! And this time we're gonna check out all the non-creature stuff. If you wanna check out my video about the creatures, about the Megatherium, the Hesperornis, the Hyenodon and the Megalania, go check it out. The link is under the information button and you can check the video out there. But this time we're gonna check out the stuff that aren't creatures.
A huge shout out to Champion Ark. They have an awesome community with several servers. Stay in contact with your tribe by getting in-game notifications when someone sends you a message through the website, or get an email notification when you're not in the game. For more information, go to championark.com/personas, scroll all the way down, claim your starter pack, and get started today!
First things first, I want to show you something how it was before. Before the update was, you can see it in your screen, when you throw stuff out and when you pick stuff up, you could see it on top of the screen. Well, here we are now. Let me throw it out. Do you see what is happening? It's on the left of the screen. And you, when you pick things up, it will be also on the left of your screen. Alrighty, the first thing I want to show you is this thing. It's the harpoon gun or the harpoon launcher. Check how cool it looks. Awesome. And this one uses the spear bolts that were previously named ballista bolt. So that is the ammo that you see now, but it also comes with a different ammo. Check it out. A huge ass dart on top of it. Damn, that dart is even bigger than my head. Oh my god. Well, almost. But it is a big dart. And I'm curious, how much torpor will it do? So let's check it out on this one. Zero torpor it has now, so let's shoot it. Let's check it out. It goes up, even further, and it stops at 306, and that was with this gun, 100% weapon damage. And check the animation of putting stuff in it. Do you see it? You use a stone to push it in. Let's show it again. How awesome is that? That is so cool. So let's see what kind of damage this one will do. So let's dive in the water. We see some sharkies over there. And let's see if we can shoot them from here, because they shoot pretty far. There it goes. Yes, I hit it! Did you see the big distance that I could hit it? Oh my god! So this one, I had that one in my hand. So let's check it out again. Come on, hit the shark. Hit it. 277. Okay. That's good to know. Well, and if you want to use this one on land, it doesn't shoot really far. Check it out. I cannot even hit that one. Dang, so you need to aim up higher to be able to hit it. Oh, I do now 120 damage. Okay, so maybe underwater you do more damage to creatures underwater than to creatures on land. That could be a thing. Because let's shoot this fish. Yeah, 277. So maybe that's a thing indeed. But yeah, on land or out of the water, you cannot shoot really far. And I'm curious, if I'm underwater now, will it shoot now much further away? No, it doesn't even reach the beach. Oh, let's check it out again. There I shoot. And no, it landed in the water. And to prove it, here they are. So that doesn't work. And you can learn the harpoon at level 43. And the spears that you need... The spear bolt can be learned at level 29, and the Trank spear bolt can be learned at level 72. Well, the next thing I'm gonna show you is the motorboat. Check it out. You need to be level 57 to learn it, and you need a lot of metal ingots for it and some black pearls and that kind of stuff. So you can craft it in a fabricator, and you need to put gasoline in it so you can speed up. So let's toss it in the water. There it is. Damn, this looks nice. Okay, let's put an armor raft next to it. Okay, there we have the armor raft, and here we have the motorboat. Damn, it is just a normal raft, but it looks much cooler. Check it out, metal all around it. So yeah, this one also has more hit points. In a moment we're gonna find out how much more hit points, because I wanna check that out. Can we check that out here? No. But yeah, let's put some fuel in it. There we go. And now we... Oh, it's... You can put it on. And then drive. There we go. Oh my god, it has an awesome sound. Oh my god, this is cool. How awesome is this? Oh my freaking lord, this is so cool. Okay, let's turn. Mew. Okay, I spawned a lead chickadee scene, so let's see how much damage this one can take. How much hit? Come on, that's one hit. That's two hits. Hit number three. Hit number four. Hit number five. And that was it. Six hits. Okay, let's see how much damage this one can take. It does 603 damage. It has like 3k damage reduction. That is so cool. So yeah, the motorboat is losing 600 health per hit. So that's 3k damage less than with the normal raft. So that means the lead has to hit this one 6 times before it has the amount of damage done like a normal raft in one go. Or with one bite. So this one is really strong. Let's see. Can we outrun them? There it is, there it is. Come on. Can we still outrun them? Oh, don't turn around, don't turn around. There we go. Yes, the motorboat is faster. Check it out. Bye bye. We are way faster than you. Until we're out of gasoline. Yes, we can outrun the lead chickadees with the motorboat. Awesome. Okay, time to test how many objects we can put on it, because that is now unknown on the wiki. I have now 88 things on it. I have 30 mortar and pestles on that side. 27 here and 3 here, so that is 30. Then I have 5 foundations and 5 ceilings, so that is 70. Then I have 10 greenhouse walls around it, so that is 80. And here are another 8 mortar and pestles, so this is 88. That's the max structure limit unofficial on the normal raft. So let's see how much stuff more we can put on this one. Alright, there we have it. So on this side I put 20 mortar and pestles. And on this side 30. So 50 more items on it. That is a lot. 50 more, damn. So in total you can put 138 items on top of your raft. Oh my god, this is so cool. This is really awesome. So I bet in the future we're gonna see a lot of cool creations with the motorboat. A lot of cool designs. And they also added new achievements, as you can see here. Here are my achievements I already got. Here are the new ones. We had in total 6. Now we have 31. So 25 more achievements. And there are some nice ones and really hard ones as well. Like finding all explorer nodes and that kind of things. Taming every creature that you can tame. Well, with the achievements come also some of the cosmetics. Or all the cosmetics that you can learn. So if you gain achievements, then you can learn cosmetics. And the menu has changed. Check it out. This is the menu now, so for getting your hair cut. But the weird thing is, I just learned everything that I had learned previous with cosmetics. And I didn't have them all, and they also added the new one, the Viking hairstyle and facial hair. Well, I cannot show it to you because, I don't have that achievement. But the weird thing is, on single player I did have some of the hairstyles. So you can see that now in the video. Here you can see it, I have a hairstyle here unlocked, and yeah, on the multiplayer server I don't have it unlocked. So I have to ask the devs how this works, because why does it work on single player and why not on multiplayer? At least for me. So hopefully it is a bug and it will all be fixed. So apparently Simba also doesn't like it that all the hairstyles are gone. Well, and something else is new is the pack leader of the direwolves. Check it out. There are some direwolves down there. That one is level 20. Level 145. That has the red glow. And the other one is also lower. So this one, it is almost down in the snow. But that one is the pack leader. So it is like kind of an alpha. Like the Allosaurus and the Hyenodon also has that. So my bet is that one will be a little bit buffed. Will do a little bit more damage. Maybe a little bit more damage resistance. But yeah, they finally added a pack leader to the direwolves. And another thing that has changed is the tribe lock. Check it out. Here it is. So I see this for the first time. Here we see this stuff. Comments. Okay, that is okay, okay. So here we see everything that is being killed or anything like that. What do we have here? need to select one. Ah, then I can promote them, demote them, kick them, leave. Ah, okay. So that is how that stuff works. So, yeah, this has changed. Previously, the triblock was on the left side. This was in the middle, was way smaller than this. And the government was just like this, something like this on the right side. Ta-da! Here is the next magical item. It's the toilet. Oh my god, you can now go to the toilet. But there is one thing. Yeah, you can sit on it and defecate. So let's check it out. Let's press... Was it this button? What button was it? That one. Yes, we defecated. But I can pick it up. I cannot flush. But yeah, how to make it work? Well, go check it out. So we have the toilet again. Let's put it down there. Yes. And now we can connect things to it, pipes to it. So it has a water intake. So let's do it like this. Will this work? Yes, this will work. Awesome. So now we can flush it. And do you see? This one has water in it now. So let's check the difference. This one doesn't have any water. It is empty. And this one has water in it, as you can see here. How cool is that? Can he do it now? Yes! I feel refreshed! How cool is that? And I got a buff. It says refreshed. Plus 30%, 33% experience for 2 minutes. How cool is that? And if we floss it down... Do you see? There is my poop. There's my poop. Okay, we can floss it down by pressing E. Okay, let's do it. That is so cool! That is so cool! Did we get anything? Or do is it in here? Yes! Check it out, we got fertilizer! Oh my god, this is such a cool item. So, this is the toilet. My god, amazing. They changed something else, and that's about the alphas. Here you can see an alpha raptor. And, I need to get up. The alpha raptor, well, all the alphas has changed a little bit in the output of damage. So, they get a little bit of a buff. I don't know how much it is, how much the difference is. And some other small changes is right here at the bottom, at the menu, you can see disable menu music. So if you want to have music in-game but not in the main menu, you can put it out. And you see default survivor items. That means if you have it on or off, you can spawn in with default survivor items that you get. So the items when you die, you can see them here in your screen then. So, if you don't want them, because I didn't want them and I had to throw them out all the time, so yeah, now you can put it off. And other small changes are, I haven't heard them yet, but they are sounds have been added and modified to the overworld. So, if you walk through the forest and those kind of things, you can hear an Anki, the beaver, the woolly rhino, the stego, yeah, all kind of stuff. Human footsteps, they say, mounted turrets. So they added new sounds. I don't know if they are already here on the center map, but yeah, they should be on the island. Well, another thing that has been changed is this one. It's the Show Ancestors menu. So here you can see it. It still shows 1 out of 20 mutations. It doesn't show you what kind of mutation, but here you can see the ancestor line has been changed. So yeah, it is all a little bit different. And the server needs to be shut down for a restart. Yeah, so this has changed also. So, yeah, that's it. That's it. That's all I could show you about this update. So, yeah, what do you think of it? I like the harpoon gun and I like the motorboat. Oh my god, the motorboat is so cool. And of course also the toilet. It is so nice. And I like that they added more achievements for Steam. And damn, I don't like those airplanes in the air making so much noise. Damn. Why? Why are you all doing that? I'm trying to end that video here. And don't forget to check out championarc.com/Fresh Owners. Scroll all the way down, claim your starter back, and get started today. Well, that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, leave a like. Leave any thoughts about this video or whatever in the comment below. And as always, if you haven't already and you want to see more of me in the future, then smash that subscribe button like a maniac. And I'll see you all in the next video. Bye bye.